Everyone, it's Dr. Sam Robbins. Now, today I'm going to discuss my personal story with kidney damage and a high-protein diet. And this is part two in my video series about high-protein diets. Now, part one, I revealed clinical results for short-term high-protein diets and how they affect your kidneys. What type of person should not eat a high-protein diet? And also the negative effects of protein on your kidney stones. So if you haven't seen that video yet, please do so. There should be a link at the underneath this to that original first video. Now, today I'm going to talk about high protein and kidney failure. Now, I'll start off by saying that years ago, I had a business partner. I'm not going to put any names to anyone. There should be a picture here. But he was a bodybuilder. He was about 20 years older than me. And he had more experience than me. And I respected him and I trust him very much at the time. And he would always tell me that I need to eat more protein if I want to gain more muscle, especially lean muscle. And he said that I need a minimum of 2 grams per pound of body weight, and preferably 3 grams would be even better. Now, at the time, as I do now, I weigh about 200 pounds, and thus he wanted me to eat at least 400 grams daily, up to 600 grams of protein daily. Now, that's a lot of protein, all right? At the time, I was eating around 200 grams, about 1 gram per pound of body weight. However, I trusted him. I decided to go on this journey. I first doubled my protein and went to 400 grams daily. And this was honestly really hard, but I managed to do it for 1 month. I decided to eat about 50 grams with 8 meals daily. At least half of them was from protein shakes made of whey protein. And then the other half was just animal protein sources. Now, after 30 days, I noticed weight gain, all right, which probably just due to the excess, extra calories I was eating from, the 200 extra grams of protein. However, I was also very bloated and tired, all right? But listen, I made a commitment, and I started it. And then the second month, I decided to increase it to 600 grams of protein. Now, to make a long story short, I stopped 2 weeks later, all right? So I was on this high-protein diet for a total of 6 weeks. Basically, I felt like crap. I was slow and tired and fatigued all the time, all right? I bloated, my blood pressure was also higher. And keep in mind that the two major causes of kidney damage is high blood pressure and high blood sugar levels. And having too much protein, especially whey protein, also increases your blood sugar levels too. Don't forget that excess protein converts to sugar and fat. Yet, my business partner, he did this daily. Bless him, he had 100 grams of protein 7 to 8 times daily, half of it from whey protein and the other half from animal sources, whether it was chicken, beef, fish, egg whites. However, it was probably more from the whey. And let's face it, he was big and he was lean. And yes, he did take steroids. However, fast forward about 10 years later, he ended up dying of kidney disease and kidney failure. He was on dialysis for a few years and finally died. Now, was this because of the very high protein diet for all those years and years and years? I don't know. I was no longer in contact with him for many years. So I don't know the details. And who knows what else he was doing. But I can guarantee that having that much protein year after year after year for sure added stress to the kidneys, to the organs. All right. I got another story. One of my original mentors he changed my life. He was a doctor and also a bodybuilder and was also very high into high protein diets. And he would tell me to eat like a tub of cottage cheese every night, all right, which was about 100 grams of protein. Of course, I couldn't do that after a few days because I'm lactose intolerant. It was just causing me a lot of problems. But he did, and he did so for years. And unfortunately, years and years and years later, I found out that he also died of kidney failure. Now, I've had a few other bodybuilder clients who have been on very high protein diets again for years and years who also have kidney problems. And no, it's not from the steroids that they took, and they weren't taking pain medications either, which are known to cause kidney problems. The reality is that you should have enough protein to do its job, which is to repair and build, throughout the body. Build muscle, hair, skin, cells, and so forth. Anything extra will just put stress on your organs and turn into body fat. In fact, too much protein will also increase oxidation and thus does the opposite and decreases protein synthesis. I've got a video about this. I'll tell you about that in a minute. So how much protein should you have? All right. How much should you be eating daily? assuming again, you know, you're someone who's into protein is working out with weights. I honestly think that about 1 gram per pound of body weight is all you need. So if you weigh 200 pounds, eat 200 grams. And if it's coming from good quality protein, such as whole eggs, you know, free range, grass-fed bison and wild-caught salmon, and of course, whey protein isolate being one of the highest biological values as far as protein, then you probably need even less protein, all right? And if you're taking lots of steroids and similar drugs, you can probably eat a little bit more protein, but you are the rare exception. And the average person who doesn't really exercise much, they just need about half of that, basically 0.5 grams per pound of body weight. If you weigh 200 pounds, you eat 100 grams. So what are the best protein sources? I've done videos about this in the past in detail, but basically the best proteins would be pasteurized whole eggs, wild-caught salmon, grass-fed bison, and grass-fed beef. I think chicken is a really crappy source of protein. I've done an entire video about that, and there's a link to that video as well below in the description area. I'm also not a fan of dairy because milk is for babies and cow milk is for baby cows. However, small amounts of whey isolate from grass-fed cows is okay. It has the least amount of fat, sugar, and lactose. And forget that cheap, gas-producing, digestive problem, whey concentrate. All right, it's used in many products to save money, so read the labels and avoid whey concentrate. Have whey isolate. And the best vegan source of protein, I think, is non-GMO white rice protein. So let's summarize it. Personally, over the past few years, and that's this past decade, I've lowered the amount of protein I eat, especially from animal sources. You know, half my protein comes from vegetable sources now, and the other half is from animal sources, again, from really high quality animal. I haven't noticed any negative changes in my body, you know, muscle loss or any of that. However, I do have more energy. So in summary, what have we learned? Basically, high protein diets would put extra stress on your kidneys, definitely if you already have kidney problems. They do increase your risk of kidney stones. Excess protein will simply turn into sugar and body fat. You only need about maximum of 1 gram of quality protein per pound of body weight. For maximum protein synthesis, eat no more than about 40 grams per meal, all right? So if you're eating 200 grams, that would be spread over 5 meals, 40 grams each. Less protein more often is better for absorption. Also, the quality of protein matters. The better the quality, the less protein you need. Higher and higher protein diets will definitely cause a decrease in protein synthesis and increase oxidation. You do not want this. Also, very high protein diets accelerate aging and can cause earlier mortality and death. Now, below, I've got some really important links about, you know, protein videos that I've done. One of them being, for example, why chicken is worthless, everything you need to know about protein powders, how to use whey protein for maximum muscle and fat loss, the best time to have protein, whey protein for maximum muscle and weight loss, fat loss, how to eat no protein to gain more muscle, what to eat on protein fasting diets to gain muscle. Also, protein powders can also cause cancer. I've got a video about that. Also, the best vegan protein powders for health, muscle, and fat loss. Again, all that information is found below, underneath this video in the description area. As always, thanks for watching and listening, and have a very happy and healthy day.